Have you ever noticed signs like this on some bridges while you're driving? This means vehicles that weigh more than these limits should not cross the bridge. Road authorities usually impose those limits on bridges to protect them from overweight vehicles. When a bridge is found to have structural issues caused by wear and tear, or when the bridge gets close to the end of its lifespan, weight limit signs are usually implemented to reduce the risk of bridge failure. Maximum weight limit of trucks allowed by those signs is not a suggestion but a mandatory requirement. If a vehicle exceeds those limits, the driver can get in a lot of trouble and may be subject to fines. Yet seeing weight limit signs are not a cause for panic, and we will get into why in detail in this video. The first thing you need to know is that bridges are not meant to last forever, and having those rules have actually increased the longevity of many old bridges. Hi, this is Joseph and you're watching The Young Hero Engineer. In this video, we are going to take a closer look at bridge engineering and why we put weight limits on some bridges. Bridges connect our cities and provide a passage over obstacles. Although bridges are static structures, they experience a lot of dynamic loads by moving vehicles. To understand why many old bridges have weight limits, we first need to understand what those bridges are made for. Bridges built in the previous century were designed to carry commercial vehicles that were much lighter than today. Because of the increase in supply chain, goods transported by trucks have tremendously increased. This is a common trend that can be seen all around the world. But let's take a specific case, such as the US. Trucks are an essential part of the US economy. Over the past 100 years, more than 70% of all freight in the US have been moved by trucks. Heavyweight trucks can easily damage the roads and bridges of national highways. In 1913, the maximum weight of trucks allowed on US roads was 13 tons. Back then, vehicles had low weight limit capacity with top speed of 24 km an hour. Inflated tires were not invented yet, so carrying much weight was not possible. Things quickly developed over the years. Engines got better, faster and more efficient, and truck length is also increased. By 1956, gross vehicle weight was established in the US, which set the maximum allowable truck loads on US roads to be 33 tons. By 1974, gross vehicle weight increased to 36 tons. Around that time, there were more than 18 million trucks on US roads. Currently, the US maximum gross vehicle weight is 36 tons. 9 tons on a single axle and 15 tons on a tandem axle group. But to make things even more complicated, there are vehicles on US roads today with gross vehicle weight higher than 36 tons, called longer combination vehicles, or LCVs for short, which is any combination of a truck tractor and two or more trailers or semi-trailers operating on the interstate system. There are a lot more weight limit restrictions on trucks, which are different in every country and can become quite complicated, which will make this video very long. What you need to know is that gross vehicle weight is something also taken into account when designing bridges and roads. Bridges without weight limit signs can handle the maximum legal vehicle weight without any issues. Bridges built in the first half of the previous century were designed for different loads than is today. Most were truss bridges with lifespan of only 50 years. This is why the current average age of US bridges is 44 years, which indicates a serious deterioration in US public infrastructure. In fact, most of those bridges are being destroyed and replaced by newer ones, which I made an entire video on. Today, the US has 60,000 bridges under weight restrictions. This makes for 10% of US bridges. 80% of those weight-restricted bridges are located on local roadways where agricultural vehicles commonly travel, which they also got super heavy and big. Bridges are designed to last many years under good conditions. Older bridges often need weight restrictions to help prevent damage since they were designed to accommodate commercial trucks that were much lighter when compared to today's modern commercial vehicles. If a bridge cannot support the maximum legal weight of vehicles, then it needs to be weight restricted. But how do we determine if a bridge needs to be weight restricted on time without any damage or bridge failure? To explain this, first I need to explain a few important concepts in bridge design. Bridges are designed to carry loads way higher than the actual loads the bridge experiences. Engineers like to operate on safe assumptions so that bridges will never experience maximum capacity during their service life. This is known as the factor of safety. Engineers factor up loads from cars and trucks traveling on these bridges, which can help make the bridge future-proof in case of an increase in traffic volume. This results in a very conservative design, which ensures the longevity of the bridge. For example, a bridge is expected to experience 300 ton maximum load from moving trucks and other vehicles, which is determined based on traffic analysis. We can call this anticipated traffic loads. Engineers actually factor up these loads by a factor based on design codes. For example, the bridge receives a factor of 2. This means that the bridge is designed based on factored loads, which are 600 ton instead of 300 ton. Which gives a lot of assurance that the bridge will not fail if it experiences the maximum anticipated loads or even exceeds it. This is usually done through computer analysis and modeling to determine how the structure will behave based on those loads. But what if the bridge starts to experience loads close to the factor of safety loads, which is in the case of old bridges that were designed for trucks that were much lighter when compared to today's modern commercial vehicles? When those old bridges start to experience an increase in traffic volume and weight, it becomes problematic. For example, if a bridge during its design was projected to experience 50,000 daily traffic volume, but over the years the traffic volume doubles with much higher weights from commercial vehicles, which can lead to fatigue on the structural elements, which result from loading and unloading of the bridge by the moving traffic. Cracks on structural members can develop over time, and a sudden failure of joints and members can also happen, which can result in a sudden failure of a bridge. When a bridge with a 100-year lifespan experiences higher loads than it's designed for, the bridge lifespan is reduced exponentially to sometimes even a third of that period. In other words, the changes in load conditions can reduce the bridge's structural capacity. In that situation, action must be taken to reduce the damage of this bridge. And this is how we determine if a bridge is operating near its weight capacity. Bridges in most countries are subject to mandatory inspections, which are usually every 2 years. During the inspection, if evidence of wear and tear was found on the bridge or deterioration in its condition, the engineer might recommend an updated load rating analysis, which is a study to determine the current load carrying capacity of an existing bridge. If the operating level of the bridge is found to be less than the legal weight allowed by trucks and other heavy vehicles, then weight limits are imposed on the bridge. Weight limit signs stay on the bridge until the capacity is restored by remediation or bridge strengthening, or until the bridge is no longer able to carry traffic. Usually, strengthening the bridge might be a good option. This solution is usually cheaper than replacing an entire bridge. This gives the bridge more years to operate. However, in some cases on bridges with bad conditions, replacing the bridge might be the only option. The weight limit on bridges is not a cause for panic and is something put to prevent major incidents and increases the safety of the bridge. And it is the easiest and cheapest solution to increase the longevity of these bridges. The sign do not mean that this is the max weight a bridge can handle. When a bridge with a max allowable truck weight of 16 tons, it means it can support vehicles in that load across the entire length of the bridge without any issues. So if only trucks with that load travels on this bridge, the bridge will not fail. Even if the loads are exceeded, it will not lead to bridge collapse, as there is still an element factor of safety implemented. Still, excessive loads from overweight vehicles on bridges with weight limits can damage the bridge over time, which can lead to a sudden failure. Weight limit signs are heavily enforced on bridges. Signs are usually implemented along highways to indicate that there is an upcoming bridge with weight limits so that overweight trucks can take a different route. Weight stations are also available to determine the gross vehicle weight of trucks. Overweight vehicles sometimes are required to get a permission to cross a bridge with weight limit. Vehicles that do not obey traffic laws and weight limits are fined heavily and can even be liable to repair costs in extreme situations. Sometimes there is also a speed limit on heavy and overweight vehicles because they introduce a lot of vibration on the bridge. Higher speeds can increase the wear and tear on roads, causing them to deteriorate more quickly. Lower speed limits for trucks can help reduce this impact. It is impossible to design bridges that last forever. We can only design bridges to last for a certain period, given that it is kept well maintained. This is why weight limit signs must be obeyed at all times. Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more interesting topics like this, and I will see you in the next video. Cheers!